Hi, and welcome to Ivy League Analytical English. I'm Angela.
And I'm Wesley.
Today is the 17th of August. We're on page 52 of the magazine, and today we're talking about chocolate. Yes.
Yep, 今天我们要谈的是巧克力.
And we're talking about a very famous, very old chocolate company. Even when I was a kid, a Cadbury chocolate egg was like a big deal. Because that was actually their new product at the time. It was literally like this giant egg that you could hold in both of your hands, which was a shell. Inside was full of like cream, sweet cream. And it was like...
Very unhealthy.
Totally unhealthy. And totally like the object of my desire for several years running as a child.
Yeah, 看到这个 Cadbury, 这个巧克力呢, Angela就想到她的小时候, 这个很喜欢吃的他们的巧克力. Yeah.
So let's talk about Cadbury chocolate. Let's read the article. And now I need chocolate. Just how delicious is Cadbury chocolate? Here are a few clues for you. It has the stamp of approval from the Queen of England. It inspired author Roald Dahl to write Charlie and the Chocolate Factory. And there are two tourist attractions based on the company's products. Let's start with the Queen. In 1854, 30 years after Cadbury was founded by John Cadbury in Birmingham, England, Cadbury was awarded its first royal warrant from Queen Victoria. A royal warrant indicates a particular company supplies goods to the royal family, which suggests they are of superior quality. It's a bit like saying, "The Queen approves of this product." Cadbury wasn't always a leader in the world of chocolate. In fact, Cadbury was originally known more for selling tea and coffee. By the time John Cadbury's sons, Richard and George, took over the company in 1861, the future looked bleak. Sales had fallen, and Cadbury was actually losing money. The sons managed to turn the company around in the span of 5 years by focusing more on chocolate and improving quality. As a type of market survey in the 1920s, Cadbury would send samples of their new chocolates to school kids to get their opinions on them. One of these testers was none other than Roald Dahl, who was inspired to write Charlie and the Chocolate Factory decades later. Cadbury also introduced fancy boxes, packaging candy in containers designed to look pretty, including heart-shaped ones for Valentine's Day. Other candy and chocolate companies continue to copy this marketing concept to this day. To further their branding, the company opened two tourist attractions called Cadbury World. The first Cadbury World was opened in 1990 in Birmingham, England, while the second followed in Dunedin, New Zealand, in 2003. Perhaps a young visitor to one of those facilities will someday go on to create a famous piece of fiction about chocolate as well. We don't need to have a fiction about chocolate. The real thing is too good already.
我们不需要一个虚构的东西,关于巧克力,我们不需要虚构的,因为它真正的巧克力已经够好吃了。We
just need a lifetime supply of it, that's what we need.
Except
that global warming is kind of threatening chocolate production.
Oh, yeah.
So that's a sour note to introduce. That's a
dun sound. Yeah. 我想我们之前有讲过一篇文章,这个全球暖化呢, 其实已经威胁到巧克力的这个生产了。
Please God, no. Okay, so I love the intro to this article because that is a question that you could say the answer to immediately. Just how delicious is Cadbury chocolate? Very delicious, or reasonably delicious, to be honest.
Yeah. 所以呢,这个一开头蛮好玩的,问了一个问题。所以究竟这个Cadbury的这个 chocolate到底有多好吃呢?
Pretty darn good.
Okay.
PDG.
PDG, pretty darn good. Darn.
Darn is not that strong.
Yeah.
Otherwise it'd be PFG.
Okay.
Which we're not going to say on the air.
Yeah. Well, cursing in Chinese is not so delicate. You know,
well, no. Here's the thing. Mm-hmm. Actually, cursing in English is way more socially acceptable than cursing
in
Chinese. It occupies an entirely different niche of language use.
Yeah.
In English, cursing is just something you do to add emphasis.
Mm-hmm.
Whereas in Chinese, you can actually really offend people.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah. 所以这个是文化差别哈。在这个中文里面呢，这种 骂人的话、脏话呢，其实是比较不容易被接受的啊。但是英文里面呢，其实很多我们所谓的脏话，在英文里面其实只是用来加强语气用的。所以像刚刚那个啊，我讲这个 darn 这个字呢，啊，其实是从 damn 这个字来的啊。
Yeah.
damn 太强了，那他们就会用一个 darn， 但是基本上都是这个在中文来看的话，都是骂人的话啊。所以在英文里面 ，darn 这个字听起来没什么太大的严重性，但是在中文你如果把它翻成啊，这个、可恶啊、妈的啊，听起来都是好像在骂人的。
Yeah, it just sounds terrible.
Yeah, 所以听起来就不好了。Yeah,
but in English it just sounds fine. You're just like emphasizing it. It's okay.
Yeah, 但在英文里面呢，你它只是用来强调语气而已。
Although you know words like Jesus,、
mm-hmm.
God, and、
oh, yeah.
the F word,、
mm-hmm.
depending on your audience, those can be really bad. So if you don't know your audience, avoid、mm-hmm. those.
Yeah.好，不过呢
even、嗯、shit you should avoid.
Yeah, 好，所以这个其实像那个 F 那个字呢，啊，或者是跟宗教有关的，哈，这个 Jesus 哈，或者是什么，甚至于 My God 这个东西啊
，Yeah，
都尽量要避免，因为我注意到很多人学英文很喜欢说 Oh my God 啊，这觉得好像听起来很有趣啊什么的，但是其实在英文的文化里面呢，你随这个没事就把上帝拿出来挂在嘴上。很多人听了会觉得很不高兴。
So you can substitute. You say, oh my gosh, everyone is okay.
Yeah, 你用 gosh 就比较好一点，不要用 God.、
So, back to our article. Just how delicious is Cadbury chocolate? Here are a few clues for you. Here are a couple reasons why you should know that it's delicious. Or how you can know it's delicious.
Yeah, 所以这里我们先讲一下，有一些 clues, 一些线索、啊、给你，让你想一想它有多好吃。
What's the difference between why and how?You would think it's pretty clear, but I was actually asked this by an 8-year-old the other day. Why is the reason for、mm-hmm. something, and how is the method by which you do it?、
Mm-hmm.
So why、yeah. is the sky blue, or how is the sky blue? That sounds like the same question,、
mm-hmm.
but why is, the answer is outer space plus sunlight. How is the sunlight hits the molecules of the air and causes a color interference reaction?、
Mm-hmm.
So how is the explanation, why is the reason?
Yeah, 好，所以这个 why 跟 how 的差别呢，其实你从中文来想也蛮容易分的哈。why 就是为何啊，但是呢 how 是如何啊，所以 how 形容的是一件事情它如何进行，或者是它的状态的程度是怎么样，但是 why 讲的是 reason， 为何讲的是原因跟理由。
So how do we know that Cadbury chocolate is delicious? First of all, it has the stamp of approval from the Queen of England. If the Queen likes itIf it's good enough for the queen, it's good enough for us.
所以呢，首先第一个，它有 stamp， stamp 就是一个戳章啊，一个印章啊。但是 stamp of approval 就是有一个认可的一个章啊，等于说认可盖了一个章了。而且这个章是谁从哪里来的呢？是从英国女王那里来的啊。所以刚刚 Angel 讲那个，好 ，if it's good for the queen for the queen of England， 如果对英国女王来讲这个够好了，那 it's good for you 啊 ，it's good enough for you， 对你来讲应该也够好了。
And the second way by which we can know it's very delicious is that it inspired author Roald Dahl to write Charlie and the Chocolate Factory. So it inspired a book.
那第二个原因我们知道它多好吃呢，是它 inspired， 它启发了一个灵感，激发了灵感。激发谁的灵感呢？一位作家，这个罗尔德·达尔，他写了什么东西？他写了一个查理与巧克力工厂。所以他好吃到这个一个人，这个作家被他这个 inspire 就是说啊，我一定要写一本书关于这个巧克力。
And the third way we know it's good is comparatively weak. I mean, after you've talked about the Queen of England and you know books written about it, then you're like, and there are two tourist attractions based on the company's products, which is like, But the thing is, things have to come in threes, so our author had to come up with a third thing. So, yeah. weak but true.
好，那第三个理由呢，跟前面两个比起来稍微好像弱一点，但是。基本上我们需要三个啊，才能够达到某种平衡啊。所以呢，这个第三个理由是什么呢？是有两个啊 ，tourist attractions 就是这个景点啊 ，tourist attractions 就吸引人的地方啊。Based on 就是以什么为基础或者根据啊，这家公司的产品啊，所以这家公司的产品，换句话说，它已经受欢迎到什么程度呢？它有两个观光景点啊，是跟这个产品根据这个产品而这个做成的，或者是制造或者是盖起来的。
But I really like the tone of this article, by the way. I like、mm-hmm. how it's very chatty, and it just feels like your friend talking to you, because it's、mm-hmm. like, just how delicious is it? Well, here's some clues.、
Mm-hmm.
And then the next paragraph starts by saying, let's start with the queen. This is like a very direct way to be like, Okay, we're going to talk about this. Let's start with the first thing.
好，所以这个文章呢，它的这个 tone 其实相当的 chatty， 好像他在跟你聊天一样，所以读起来你会觉得很自在、很舒服啊。所以他第二段呢，一开始就说 Let's start with the queen。好，那我们先谈谈这个皇后好了啊，女王了啊。所以他这个感觉起来就是慢慢的一步一步带你啊，跟你聊天一样啊。那我们现在先看看女王怎么说好了。
And also for me, the queen is the most interesting thing about this article. Like, I had no idea that Cadbury was approved by the queen. But in 1854, 30 years after Cadbury was founded by John Cadbury in Birmingham, England. So we always have to get these details in when we talk about a company. So our author has slipped it in a very casual and natural way. We get the information without it being the lead on the sentence, on the paragraph. You know, often we start by saying, in 1854... It was founded by John, you know, that's very straightforward. But here we're saying, well, it was, you know, the queen is the thing here. But by the way, this is when it started. So it's slipping the information in. So 30 years after it was founded, Cadbury was awarded its first royal warrant from Queen Victoria. So they've had more than one royal warrant. Apparently they need to be renewed. I wonder how often they need to be renewed. But they've had more than one, and they got this one from Queen Victoria. So not even the current queen, but the previous queen said, Yup, I want Cadbury's in my life.
好，所以呢，这个在1854年，那这一年怎么样呢？同位格补充一个讯息告诉你，而且他这种补充方法感觉起来是很 casual， 就这个没有特别的强调或怎么样，就顺便带入这个资讯。这个1854年是30年之后，什么东西30年之后呢？这个 Cadbury 由John Cadbury 在这个英国的 Birmingham 这个地方呢他所建立的30年之后，换句话说他是1824年建立的所以在建立了30年之后，创办这个公司30年之后呢，他 was awarded 被颁给这个 award 表示他很棒然后就颁个东西给他，颁什么给他呢？颁给他的 its first， 既然是 first 表示后来还有这是第一个什么呢？ Royal Warrant，皇室的授权这个 warrant 它就是一个它可以指一个授权或者授权书那这从哪里来的呢？哇，这个是当时的英国女王Victoria 维多利亚女王。
And a royal warrant, what is this thing? What does it mean to get a royal warrant? A warrant, have you heard of, you've certainly heard this in an American movies, they say we have a warrant for his arrest, right?
Yeah.
A warrant is basically like a certificate or an official piece of paper. Could you say that it's a 证件?
It's kind of a 证件, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, 所以 warrant 这个字呢，我们在美国电影里面常常看到那个时候是指逮捕令所以它是一个证明证明我们要来逮捕你。
So a royal warrant is like an official piece of paper from the queen and...You know, at the time, the queen is the ruler of the country, or kind of. But, yes, it's complicated in England, but it's important that it's a royal warrant. So it indicates that what it means is that this particular company supplies goods to the royal family. Goods are anything physical, like tea, clothing, porcelain, any physical thing that you need as a supply would be a good.And so they get to supply things, they get to give products to the royal family. So the royal family doesn't buy just anybody's. They only buy from companies that have already been checked out and given a royal warrant. Because the people who are getting supplies for the royal family aren't just going to buy something off the street. That wouldn't be okay. So because the royal family is willing to buy a product, this sort of implies then that the product is better quality. Because obviously, if you heard...Oh, the queen buys this. You'd be like, oh, probably it's better.
Yeah, 好，所以这个 warrant 我们刚刚讲是一个证明但是它其实它证明了什么？它证明的是一个授权所以逮捕令也是一种这个证明，说这个法院授权来把你逮捕。所以这个地方看到它的一个 royal warrant 因为我们刚刚讲一个皇室的授权呢 ，indicates 就是它 shows 它显示出a particular company 某一个特定的公司。Supplies 在这里是动词供应。某一个公司呢，它供应 goods 货物给这个皇家 the royal family。那这个表示怎么样呢 ？Which suggests 这表示说呢，这家公司所供应的这些货物呢是 are of superior quality。superior 在这里就是 本来就是比较好的，但在这里其实就是 of high standard 或者是 quality， 所以 to be of superior quality 表示它的品质非常的好啊。所以这个皇家的授权或者是一个证明，证明说啊，这家公司它有供应货物给皇家，那其实就表示说这个东西，这家公司的货物品质很好。
And so our author, having given you the formal definition, then slips back into much more relaxed tone and says, "It's a bit like saying the Queen approves of this product."
这就有好像有一点好像说啊，这 "It's a bit like saying" 就是中文讲的，这有点像是说的意思啊，这有点像是说女王 approves of this product 啊。女王呢认可这些产品啊 ，approves of 要注意 approve 这个字呢后面有没有加 of 意思不一样，不加 of 的 approve 是核准批准的意思，但是 approves of 是认可的意思啊，所以这个地方是认可，就是认可这个产品啊，说这个产品可以够好啊，可以供应给皇家。
And you can use this technique that the author just did in your own papers. It's a nice thing to do. You state the main sentence, which is a royal warrant indicates a particular company supplies goods to the royal family, etc. You state the formal definition, and then you restate it in more common, accessible language. That way you've given them the proper definition, you've given them the real thing, and then you've told them, which it basically means, 某某东西, like it basically means this. And that way you've restated the point, which is important to do in Western writing, to restate your point more than once, but this way it's done in a fun way, it's memorable, and it's also a good way to conclude your paragraph, like our author has done.
嗯哼，好，所以这个大家可以学起来哈，就是你先讲一个比较正式的一个定义，然后后面再加一句 "It's a bit like saying" 啊，感觉听这个就好像有点是说什么啊，有点好像是说什么什么。那这样子的话，就可以把你刚刚讲的比较正式的那个定义呢，你可以用一个比较平常的话把它解释出来啊。而且这可以用来做一个段落的结束，也相当的好。
So on our third paragraph, it says, Cadbury wasn't always a leader in the world of chocolate. And this is always true, it seems, of these very long-lived companies. Often companies change their product line or their focus over time.
好，所以 leader 是领导者，或者是龙头，某个产业的龙头。所以这 Cadbury 并不是一直是巧克力世界的龙头，换句话说，他们的产品有变化过。
In fact, Cadbury was originally known more for selling tea and coffee, which were the popular stimulants of their day. They're still popular. But I mean, tea and coffee, tea was originally the big thing and then coffee came up. So probably they started with tea, diversified into coffee, and then were like, yeah, let's do chocolate.
事实上呢 ,Cadbury 它 originally, 它本来是was known for, 或者 more for, 它比较有名的 ,to be known for 是有名，那 was known more for 什么什么，就是它什么东西比较有名的，它原来比较有名的是卖茶跟咖啡。
Now, by the time John Cadbury's sons, Richard and George, took over the company in 1861, the future looked bleak, because, as any long-lived company will tell you, times go up, times go down.So actually, their first royal warrant for Queen Victoria was probably for tea and coffee and not chocolate.
Yeah. 好，那他的这个儿子们 Richard 跟 George took over the company, 就是接手这个公司，在1861年的时候，他们的状况其实怎么样？ The future looked bleak. Bleak 就是 not hopeful, not encouraging. 好，所以这句话 the future looked bleak, 大家可以把它背起来，它就是中文讲的前景暗淡。
So sales had fallen. People were not, probably didn't care as much that the queen liked this tea, and there's probably, you know, cooler, hipper tea and coffee companies around. And so Cadbury was actually losing money, which is never a good thing.
Sales, 就是销售量。Sales had fallen, 它的销售量下降。而且呢，这个公司其实，事实上呢，was actually losing money. 它事实上在亏钱。
And as is not always common when sons take over from their fathers, they managed to turn the company around. And they did it in the span of 5 years, which is pretty quick for that era. And they did it by focusing more on chocolate and improving quality. They're like, okay, what are people not selling? Where's our better? What's one of our products that doesn't have too much competition? Probably went something like that.
所以这两个儿子呢 managed to, 就经过一番努力之后呢，他们 turn the company around, 就扭转的局势。而且呢在短短五年之中 span 就是 a period of time, 所以在五年这样的一个时间之内呢，扭转的局势。那怎么做呢？他们把重心比较放在巧克力上面， focusing more on chocolate， 而且呢 improving quality， 然后呢改善他们的品质，改良他们的品质。
So as a type of market survey in the 1920s, as a way of gauging public opinion, Cadbury would send samples of their new chocolates to school kids to get their opinions on them. And honestly, this explains a lot about Charlie and the Chocolate Factory.
好，所以呢 ，as a type of 就作为一种怎么样 market survey 一个市场调查，而且是1920年的这种市场调查呢，他们会would 就表示过去常常做的事情，他们会给一些样品，他们新的巧克力的样品给学校的孩子们，给送到学校去给孩子们吃，来怎么样 get their opinions on them 啊，来得看看他们的意见怎么样。那这个大家就看得过查理与巧克力工厂的话，就会想到哦，原来这中间有这样的一些关联。
Just to give you a little perspective on this, at the time in the 1920s, snacks were not nearly as common as they are in our world now. It's not like kids got, you know, potato chips and sodas every day. So if you were a kid who was suddenly sent a box of chocolate, it probably really much felt like a golden ticket had fallen in your lap.
好，所以1920年代的小孩其实没有什么零食可以吃，所以你可以想象当时如果收到这种 samples 的话，对小孩子会有造成多大的影响。
And imagine your social capital suddenly. You could hand out chocolates to people.
而且你要想到他，你可以把东西巧克力这样给别人吃啊，这是不容易的。
So one of these testers, one of the kids who was given a box of chocolate was none other than Roald Dahl, and that inspired him to write Charlie and the Chocolate Factory decades later.
None other than 就是不是别人，正是啊。所以呢，这些 testers 这些吃巧克力试验品这个样品的人呢。其中之一不是别人，正是我们这个查理与巧克力工厂的这个作者啊，他是在数十年之后写出了这本书。
Another thing Cadbury influenced was fancy packaging by introducing their fancy boxes. And I love that this is a title, so this must be what they're actually called at Cadbury. Fancy box.
Yeah.
And it's what it is they package candy in containers designed to look pretty.Including heart-shaped ones for Valentine's Day. And I remember in grade school looking at these heart-shaped boxes in the store and wanting one so bad.
Yeah. 好，那这家公司也很聪明啊，他们引入了所谓的 fancy boxes, 啊，它是一种精致的包装盒。不过这里它都用大写表示这是他们一种产品的名字啊，那个漂亮的包装盒。各位可以去 Google, 图片里面就看到很多它这个东西啊。
Fancy box.
Yeah.那这个 packaging 啊，他们把这个糖果包装在一些 container 这些容器里面，但这些容器呢是 designed to look pretty 啊，这容器看设计起来就很漂亮。那包括怎么样心形的容器啊，在情人节的时候他们会有心形容的这个盒子啊，装这些糖果。
And so other candy and chocolate companies continue to copy this marketing concept to this day, which means that in the United States, people now talk about February 15th.The day when you can buy half-price chocolate.
Yeah. 所以呢这个 copy, 所以其他公司呢就模仿这种 marketing concept, 这种行销概念。一直到今天其他的公司还在模仿这种行销概念。
So to further their branding, which means to spread their marketing to a wider audience, the company opened two tourist attractions called Cadbury World.
好，那这个进一步的要打造他们的品牌 ,branding 就是打造品牌。他们开设了两家这个两个地方啊，这个旅游景点称为吉百利世界。
I will be so disappointed if I find out that Cadbury World doesn't have a chocolate fountain that you can go swimming in. Although that would be deeply unsanitary.
他们也许有那个巧克力喷泉吧。
Now the first Cadbury World was opened in 1990 in Birmingham, England, and the second followed in Dunedin, New Zealand in 2003. So literally on two opposite poles of the world.
Yeah, so 1990年呢他们第一家这个吉百利世界啊在英国啊 Birmingham 这个地方开幕了。然后第二个是在2003年在纽西兰的这个Dunedin 这个地方开幕。
Perhaps a young visitor to one of those facilities will someday go on to create a famous piece of fiction about chocolate as well.
也许啊某一个年轻的这个去参观这些巧克力工厂的人呢好，也许或者这个巧克力景，这个景观光景点的地方，有一天会 go on 进一步的，他会创作啊，这个一个 有名的 piece of fiction 另这个小说，那 as well 就是也会写一个小说，因为前面已经有人写过了哈，这个前面查理与巧克力工厂，所以也许另外一个人也会写一本有名的小说。
So that's the end of the first half of the article, and tomorrow we'll do the second half of the article. And now I have to go find some chocolate. See you later. Bye-bye.